This matter. Did not make a motion.
Supervisor Martin.
Aye.
Councilman Ambrosino. Councilman Cullen. Councilman Darcy.
Aye.
Councilman Boosby.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed local law regarding parking or standing prohibitions in Fallman, Belmore, East Meadow, Island Park, Merrick, and Oceanside.
Does anybody wish to be heard on that, this matter? Not made a motion.
Yes, Supervisor, I move the public hearing be closed and the proposed local law be adopted.
Supervisor Martin.
Aye.
Councilman Ambrosino.
Aye.
Councilwoman Cullen. Councilman Darcy.
Aye.
Councilman Boosby.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Again, thank you to the students of Sawanica who are exiting to get back to school. Thank you for your hard work. Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed local law regarding arterial stops in Fallman, Oceanside, and Woodman.
Does anybody wish to be heard on this matter? Made a motion.
Yes, Supervisor, I move the public hearing be closed and the proposed local law be adopted.
Supervisor Martin.
Aye.
Councilman Ambrosino.
Aye.
Councilwoman Cullen. Councilman Darcy.
Aye.
Councilman Boosby.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes. Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed handicap parking on public streets in Franklin Square.
Does anybody wish to be heard on this matter? Made a motion.
Move that the public hearing be closed and the proposed handicap parking be adopted.
Supervisor Martin.
Aye.
Councilman Ambrosino.
Aye.
Councilwoman Cullen. Councilman Darcy.
Aye.
Councilman Boosby.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase and improvement of Town Hempstead Street Lighting District.
Donna Casaza, do you want to be here on this?
Okay.
Anybody else?
Yes, I'd like to be here.
Good morning, please share your name with us.
Felix Locacci, 1165 Orange Street, Franklin Square, New York. Before I start, do I, Mr. Santino, request that I state my political disclosure statement, or I bypass that? It's up to you. Per Councilman Santino's request, I am providing a summary of my recent political activities. The stated belief is, since I do not mention that I was a candidate for town supervisor against Kate Murray before I speak at town board meetings, that I am somehow misleading residents of my intentions. Last year, I, a Republican, was selected by the Democratic Party as a candidate for town supervisor. I ran on a platform of transparency, because Supervisor Murray opposes any form of comprehensive transparency in the Hempstead town government. Prior to my nomination, I attended every town board meeting since August 2010. My one and only endorsement of the campaign came from the Rockville Center Tea Party Patriots, for which I am not a member. The endorsement came shortly after I gave my one and only presentation at their October 2013 meeting. The Tea Party are primarily conservative and Republican Party members. Councilman Santino's accusation that I participate in partisan Democratic Party activities is untrue. His rambling on this seems to be only an intentional distraction because he himself cannot justify his anti-transparency position. I hope this brief presentation assures Councilman Santino that I am not afraid of being fully transparent, unlike Supervisor Murray and the rest of the Hempstead Town Board. If not, I am more than willing to discuss this transparency issue at this or any other town board meeting to ensure residents are always well informed.
Do you have a question?
Mr. Santino requested that I do this, so I want to be thorough. Yes, I do have questions. I don't know if it's appropriate, but it's basically the same thing through all those bond referendums in the... I'm talking on particular Franklin Square Park District, but there are huge swings in the budget. I mean, this has to do with borrowing more money for the Franklin Square Park District, more money for the lighting district, more lighting for all the various districts that are mentioned here. But, for example, within the last 2 years, my Franklin Square Park District has increased from $2.4 million to $3.8 million. So we spent an additional $2 million so far. I sit on the building committee at Sewanee High School, where these children came from. For $2 million, we could put in two synthetic fields. I go to Rath Park regularly, that's the Franklin Square Park District. My daughter's on the swim team. I'm there all the time, all summer long. My son plays soccer. I haven't seen $2 million of improvements. It's thrown in that interfund item on those, all those districts have an interfund appropriation item. And the money's in each of these districts, sometimes it goes up. Liz Stone spoke here on a public hearing back on September 17th. I have a disc if you want to listen to it. For 45 minutes, she had an attorney, she had a traffic expert, not one bell went off. Not one bell went off in a public hearing. And she had multiple people speaking here. I'm here by myself, me against everyone else who's going to start yelling at me, and the bell lady. I deserve the same treatment everyone else. If I deserve to be belled at 3 minutes, then Liz Stone deserves to be belled at 3 minutes too.
Mr. Patrick,
okay?
We're just trying to move it along.
No, you're not trying to move it along. You're trying to...
That you can't speak?
Why is that bell going off? Why is that bell going off?
Because of 3 minutes.
No, public hearings are never held till 3 minutes. That's a special rule you started making up. I have video of it. But it's all relevant. If you can't speak, you can't get your voice heard. And you treat me differently, and I'm being very polite to you. I'm trying to just ask the questions about how this money's being spent, and I'd like some answers. Why are these wild swings in these special, so-called special districts or park districts? All of them go up a half million, up 2 million, down a million.
But they all generally reflect, since you're wanting to talk about all of them, they all generally reflect infrastructure improvements in that particular district. That's a generic, but that's a real answer for essentially for each one of these proposals before you.
Yeah. I went to the. I came here early today.
Yes, I know. You met with Mr. Capabianco at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, but also I came even earlier, and I spoke with Michelle Hansen, and about because the law that Governor Cuomo passed on February 2nd. Well, it got enacted on February 2nd, 2012. Requires that the details of resolutions be put on a high-speed website prior to the meeting. I came to the town clerk's office thinking I would get some additional information besides the fact that $200,000 additional money is going to be spent on top of the $2 million of new fund transfers, which are kind of a mystery. Why can't some of that money, $2 million in 2 years, over $2 million in 2 years, why can't that be used and avoid a lot of these bond referendums, which are going to require tax increases? Interfund transfers within the Franklin Square Park District. Mm-hmm. My base tax, my taxes have gone up over the last 2 years, even though with the tax rules. The primary driver of that is the Park District, in which the tax rate, for some reason, doubled from 2012 to 2014. The tax rate doubled and the budget went from $2.4 million to $3.8 million. So now that was a million, and it went from, I think the first year went from 2.4 to 3.4, then went from 3.4 to 3.8. But that's $2 million of expenditures that you're doing, of operating expenditures. My question really is, since you have all this additional money to put into operating expenditures, why can't some of that money be transferred to capital improvements, as Mr. Conroy said, so you don't have to bond it? You have that $2 million. I'm not sure why we have $2 million of additional operating expenditures over the last 2 years. And, you know, the current budget is the rather dividing when you're borrowing money. Because I don't know if that money's being utilized correctly.
Supervisor, to reiterate what I said, the operating inter-fund transfer, just using terms, is an operating cost. An operating cost is a periodic cost that has a benefit of less than 1 year, cannot be capitalized, hence cannot be borrowed against, because there is no benefit in future years. You can't take operating money and put it into a capital expenditure. That would not be appropriate, that would be in violation of
okay, well, then I guess the question is, why did the operating expenses increase over $1.4 million in 2 years?
The operating expenses in that park district follow the deployment of the resources in a specific account.
Okay, let me address what you talked about paying down the debt, since you did bring it up, and it is an issue. This is from the Consolidated Annual Financial Report. In 2003, the general bond obligations, right from the report, was $238 million. And in 2012, the latest report is $317 million.
Are you still talking about the RAF?
Well, it has to do with what you just brought up. You brought up the fact that you're paying down debt. The fact is that from 2009 to current day, you brought up the fact that you're paying down debt. From 2009 to current day, you've been increasing the debt. The debt has actually gone up. Okay, but don't bring it, then you brought up this additional item. I didn't bring it up. So I just don't understand why this isn't, why it's not relevant to current operating expenses. Because if you have additional $2 million spent in operating expenses, you could spend it somewhere else. And everybody deserves to be treated equally. I got the that law that was passed back in the year 2000 that shows the conduct of the union. Nothing says that people should be treated differently. I ordered the Robert rules of order. Nothing says that people should be treated.
Mr.
Perpetua,
do you want to just?
I just wanted to.
Do you have a question on the table?
I'm done for this.
Okay. Is anybody else who should be heard on? Call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase and improvement of County Hempstead Park District. Supervisor Murray?
Aye.
Councilman Evansino?
Aye.
Councilman Cullen?
Aye.
Councilman Darcy?
Aye.
Councilman Goosby?
Aye.
Councilman Hughes?
Aye.
Councilman Santino?
Aye.
Proposed increase in improvement of town of Hempstead Park District.
Then I wish to be heard in this matter. Not many.
Does the public hearing be closed and the proposed increase in improvement be adopted?
Supervisor Murray?
Aye.
Councilman Evansino? Councilman Cullen?
Aye.
Councilman Darcy?
Aye.
Councilman Goosby?
Aye.
Councilman Hughes?
Aye.
Councilman Santino?
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase and improvement of Franklin Square Park District.
Does anybody besides Mr. Picacci wish to be heard? May I have a motion?
I move that the public hearing be closed and the proposed increase and improvement be adopted.
Supervisor Murray?
Aye.
Councilman Evansino?
Aye.
Councilman Cullen?
Aye.
Councilman Darcy?
Aye.
Councilman Goosby?
Aye.
Councilman Hughes?
Aye.
Councilman Santino?
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase and improvement of Hewlett Park District.
Does anybody wish to be heard on this matter? May I have a motion?
Yes, Supervisor. I move public hearing to close and proposed increase and improvement of Hewlett Park District be approved.
Second.
Supervisor Murray?
Aye.
Councilman Evansino?
Aye.
Councilman Cullen?
Aye.
Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase in improvement of town Hempstead refuge district, disposal district.
Is there any chamber on this side? I have a motion.
Move the public hearing to close and the proposed increase be adopted.
Second.
Supervisor Myers.
Aye.
Councilman Abrosino. Councilman McCullough. Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase in improvement of East Meadow Water District.
Is there any chamber on this side? I have a motion.
Move the public hearing to close and the proposed increase be adopted.
Supervisor Murray.
Aye.
Councilman Abrosino.
Aye.
Councilman McCullough. Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase in improvement of Levittown Water District.
Is there any chamber on this side? I have a motion.
Move the public hearing to close and the proposed increase be adopted.
Supervisor Murray.
Aye.
Councilman Abrosino.
Aye.
Councilman McCullough. Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed increase in improvement of Roosevelt Field Water District.
Is there any chamber on this side? I have a motion.
Move the public hearing to close and the proposed increase be adopted. Roosevelt Field Water District.
Supervisor Murray.
Aye.
Councilman Abrosino.
Aye.
Councilman McCullough. Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Proposed amendment of Chapter 40 of the Building Zone Ordinance of the Town of Hempstead entitled the Hempstead Turnpike Elm Zoning District, HTE, Town of Hempstead.
Does anybody wish to be heard on this matter? I have a motion.
Move the public hearing to close and the proposed increase be adopted. Roosevelt Field Water District.
Second.
Supervisor Murray.
Aye.
Councilman Abrosino.
Aye.
Councilwoman McCullough. Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilwoman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the next public hearing.
Application of Hard Place Realty Inc. for variance from provisions of GSS ordinance to build a convenience store, setback variance required.
Good morning. Sue Weinstein, I'm here on the street. This is pretty comprehensive. I just have one question. What are the current hours of operation and how will they vary with the installation of the store?
Current hours of operation are 24 hours. We are looking to remain 24 hours.
Okay. That's really my only question.
Thank you.
Is anybody else? Not me.
Supervisor Murray. Councilman Abrosino.
Aye.
Councilman McCullough. Councilman Dossi.
Aye.
Councilman Guzzi.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye.
Please call the administrative calendar, noting that item number 66 has been administratively resolved already.
Yes, Madam Supervisor, I will at this time move the administrative calendar in its entirety, with the exception of item number 66, which has already been acted upon by the board.
Supervisor Murray.
Does anybody else want to be heard on anything?
Madam 243, Charlie 26th. I have a question, actually, item 12 and 13, if you wouldn't mind explaining to me, item 12. Item number 12 and 13. So this is a generator that's in addition to whatever it's
permanently. I don't believe we have a backup generator right now, is that right?
No, the generator that's there will provide emergency lighting just for the very limited emergency lighting in the office. In the house, we've had to bring in local generators to run basic functions when lighting came out. This will be in on plan and will ensure that no matter what, they'll have a backup power source.
So I'm assuming that during Sandy, they brought in other generators, is that
yes, right? Exactly. Temporary ones. This way, we don't have to do any kind of calling of the generators to the site to be there to come into place.
Okay, and item number 13. It doesn't really specify what that money is used for. Is there any kind of, is there an item list or?
Is there
Item number 13 is supervised for $150,000. The itemization that is aging for the recovery room at $50,000 and upgrade $100,000.
And building upgrade, what are the specifics there?
I know there's some
surgical suite and the staging room for after the surgery. And for that, office upgrades in general.
Okay. Office upgrades and surgical suite?
It's surgical suite and a staging room after the surgeries they went for the staging
The urgent recovery, is that?
Yes.
Very good. Okay, thank you. So what's the matter?
Felix Picacci, 1165 Bond Street, Franklin Square. Mrs. Kazaza brought up a surgical unit for the animal shelter. What item was that?
It was an ambulance.
Ambulance.
It's a mobile surgical site.
Yeah, what number was that?
49.
That was on 49. What does that include? What equipment are we purchasing with that? And I bring it up all the time, and it is required by law. Governor Cuomo passed a law, it got enacted February 2nd, 2012, that the details of these resolutions should be online. You have a high-speed website, so it's required by law. Yes, I do, but the idea is to have these available to the public prior to the meeting. That was the idea behind the law, not to everybody can't come to these meetings and you don't want to provide them online. So you should be able to look on the website and see what details there are. It's required by law. Yes, I would like to hear about it.
Understood.
We will be going out to bid on the unit itself with everything that goes into it, and then we will be bidding separately, I believe, on the X-ray unit. And ultimately, the results of these bids, when we review them and select the lowest responsible bidder, that will give us the grand total. It may or may not be that much, but we want to ensure that we have enough to purchase.
Sure. I did some research in this area, including on the X-ray equipment. So is that the only accessory you plan on buying?
No, that if you look into it, you know that there are.
Yeah, which one are we planning on putting in?
Caging, there's, well, the bid that we're putting out is basically asking for a price list of the options available and the various configurations so that we can then decide what can best be put in.
You plan on buying new for everything here?
Yes.
Okay, because I did price out some stuff online, eBay. They had used equipment, came with warranties, like an x-ray equipment. I don't know what the new value was, but it was $20,000.
But again, Mr. Bertacci, we're a government, we can't bid on eBay. We have to do a whole bidding process as per state law. So we don't have the
so you can't buy used equipment?
Legal right to go on to eBay and bid for equipment.
Can you go on? Can you buy used equipment?
There's nothing illegal about buying used equipment, but the question is, what are you going to get? And so I think that these we're going to bid.
Okay.
These have a shelf life. They have a.
Yes, some of these equipment that I saw that they were selling on eBay, and I guess you could buy it through other distributors who sell it without going online. You just buy it directly and get the price on that piece of equipment and pick the lowest price. And I think if you're familiar with eBay, you can just click and buy that product. You don't have to bid on it. You just buy immediately.
No, the point is we have to.
No, I understand that. But if you put out the bid, for example, and you got a bunch of prices, and let's say the $20,000 number that I come up with, the one I saw, it comes with a 3-year warranty, the one that so it's not like you buy in, you have to go to a repair shop as soon as it. So you could make that purchase what maybe save the taxpayers some money.
Again, that's an option for private citizens, as I said. Okay. Your government, we're subject to state law, which requires us to go out to bid.
Okay. It just used equipment. That's something I was very like. I want to quote on, like, basically a lot of these bond referendums. Some of them specify subject to permissive referendum, and some of them don't.
The function of state law. Some of them we need to have a permissive referendum on, some of them.
What does that mean for
the function of state law?
What does that mean? It means today's the vote and today's the referendum, is that correct?
Yeah. Permissive referendum means that for 30 days, in most cases, some cases 45 days, it can't be enacted. It doesn't become law until the permissive referendum period has expired. If somebody wants to go out and get petitions to have a referendum on these items, they have to get, 5% of the voting public to sign, and then they can have actually put this to a vote. So they can be handed to us.
Okay, so I told you early. We have to go through the same thing again. It's just ridiculous. I just want to have a conversation and understand what's going on here. And she has to ring the bell.
This is a town board meeting. And
yeah, but the guy called for a long time and he didn't have a bell.
But again,
Jill Stone called for 45 minutes with three people. 45 minutes with three people.
You're taking up time. I have to stop you. So
why do I have to hear the bell? Why do I have to hear the bell? Okay, so the thing is, if people were going to do this referendum, they would have to have some understanding as to what's going into it, into the details. These items that have permissive referendums. Where would you get those details of that? Because for example, there's number 9 says subject to permissive referendum, authorizing $40,000 to the Department of Waterways. Now, before anyone would take the petition up and do any work to decide they don't want it or want it, they would have to know what that $40,000 is going to be used for.
The details are in the resolution.
But I looked at the resolution to just kind of that it's going to spend money. The details of the work that's going to be done is in there, you're saying? Okay, so I look at every one, but I guess I do realize that some of them that have permissive resolutions do have the details, and ones that don't have the details. Most of them that I went through, it just said it kind of a lot of words around it, but it didn't give any detail as to the actual work that was being performed. You understand what I'm saying? Because most of these don't have, the ones, most of these that I looked at don't have any details behind the money. So you don't know, you can't make a subjective view as to like whether it's a good deal or not, because you don't even know it's being purchased.
I would take a look at that. I believe it's that it's stationed or
I'll double check it, but yeah. Also, there's items number for the end. One is awarding a public works contract to Sardine Saraceno Contracting Corporation. And the other one is appointment of a member of the County Hempstead Housing Authority, and the name is also Saraceno. Is there any relationship between Saraceno Construction Company and the Frank J. Saraceno who being appointed to the Town of Hempstead Housing Authority?
Commissioner DeBratsky?
No relationship?
I'm calling on the sanitation commission. There has to be a public disclosure.
There would have to have been a disclosure by Saraceno.
Do you know the principles of Saraceno Construction Corp?
Yes, I don't have it.
Can I get that information?
Yes.
That's it. In the future, I'd ask the public hearings and bond, the administrative calendar items.
On the thing, the owner of Saraceno Construction Corporation is Gaspari Saraceno of Bronx, New York. Okay.
But I don't know if he's really Frank Saraceno.
Frank Saraceno is a resident of his family.
Okay, but they can still be related cousins, brothers.
There is a public disclosure.
Sure. Just ask me the question.
It's immaterial if they're related. As long as Mr. Frank Saraceno doesn't own any part of Saraceno Construction Company, they could be brothers. It doesn't matter.
No, I understand. It does give an appearance, though. I understand. In the future, can we follow state law and provide details of these public hearings as per state law? This isn't my law.
We take the position that we follow state law in all respects.
But, you know, for example, the park district and everything, I don't even know what work is being done for the $200,000. I couldn't get it from the town clerk because she had the same thing I read on the website, just as $200,000, but we don't know for what. And then you go on and on. And then you keep on ringing the bell on me, and I ask what each detail item is. Why not just provide it upfront? And that is state law.
Yeah, thank you.
Supervisor Curry. Aye. Councilman Ambrosino.
Aye.
Councilman McClellan. Councilman Darcy.
Aye.
Councilman Goosby.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes.
Aye.
Councilman Santino.
Aye. Will we adjourn, sir?
Second motion.
Supervisor Murray.
Aye.
Councilman Ambrosino.
Aye.
Councilman McCullough. Councilman Darcy.
Aye.
Councilman Goosby.
Aye.
Councilman Hughes. Councilman Santino.
Aye.
That concludes the polling portion of the meeting. Ms. Dowd.
In regards, just going back to the bidding process, did a bid happen to go out for the surgical van when it was approved to rent that surgical van at the end of the time?
That will be going out. This is authorizing the bonding. Then once we get that permission, then the department will put out the bid.
They actually circulated the permission. permission to go out for bid. I don't know the exact status, but it's imminent. They discussed it with you together.
But what I'm referring to is renting, current rental of that van at $300 a day. And previously, would a bid ever go out to rent a van?
No, it wouldn't. That's not an item that's subject to bid.
Okay, in regards to the veterinarian exam, has that been publicized at this point?
As a state poll, yes, they've been publicized.
I haven't seen no information that they've called for this.
As of last Friday, the state is not.
Okay, thank you very much.
At least now I can't go off subject, right? I have an article here that you were quoting, and I'll just ask you if the quote is correct, that you call transparency the cornerstone of your administration. You say that's correct? Absolutely. So we do have any problems with emailing residents of town board meetings and the resolutions as they currently appear on the town's website so people know the meetings exist, people who have already signed up for email alerts. Would you be willing to do that? Of course, the taxpayers no money.
They are posted on the website.
Okay, but you know, the reason why don't you just post Passport Day on the website instead of spending $70,000 of taxpayer money to notify people? Why is it so important to notify people of Passport Day and not notify them when you're spending $36 million plus the special district the bond referendum, maybe over $40 million of taxpayer money, that you don't feel it necessary to email them, but you don't mind spending $70,000 to put out this very expensive flyer? Why is that? Yeah, I'm just asking you a question. Would you like to answer?
Feel free to make a statement.
No, it's a question for you. It's a question.
It's a public comment period.
I have a question for you. Well, why do we spend $70,000 for this, but we won't even give an email alert for town board meetings and resolutions and all the money? Just why? Well, why can't you answer? Why don't we do that?
Your question is duly noted.
That's not really an answer, is that, Mr. Secretary?
My answer is.
I understand. Is that really fair to the taxpayers?
Do we know it, Mr. Secretary? Move along.
Is that fair that they not get notified? You're spending over $40 million in referendums on this calendar. And, you know, people should at least know what their money is being spent. Yeah, but why don't you put this in Newsday, though? Why don't you put this in Newsday in 5-point font? You know, people can't read that. And you understand it. You understand the power of this. And that's why you send this out when you want something to happen. That's why school district does this. We get this when they want something to happen. When they want to hide something, they say they followed state law, they put the public notices in, the small font, and that's it. And that's not fair. And that's why government's out of control. Governments don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking. That is against their interests. They want obedient workers, people who are just smart enough to run the machines, do the paperwork, and just dumb enough to passively accept it. And that's George Carlin. He did a great sketch on that. And that's exactly, this mimics what you are. You don't want people well-educated.
Thank you.
on here.